Right, let's move on with our lessons. Today we are going to look at Thevenin's theorem as our second theorem after superposition. Like I said in the previous lecture, Thevenin's theorem we're going to use it together with the superposition theorem. Basically, because we'll be calculating values even when we have more than one source in the circuit. And hence, we are also using Thevenin's theorem. Right. Now, Thevenin's theorem, it is used when you have to consider the effect of circuit components on a selected portion of your circuit. In other words, we want to look at the terminal behavior of a particular circuit, mostly under variable load. That means we want to vary our load and see how that circuit will respond. So, if you have a fixed portion of a circuit, which I'm very sure that it will not change, you can take it to be a power supply, then your interest is to see the terminal response of your circuit. And in that case, you use Thevenin's theorem. Now, if you know that you have a fixed portion of the circuit, then there will be no need for you to redo everything when you are doing calculations for the behavior of the circuit at a certain point. So, stated, we say any linear two-terminal bilateral network can be replaced by an equivalent circuit with a voltage source in series with an equivalent resistance. You have different wordings for the theorem, but what it's telling you is that there should be two-terminal bilateral linear network. And we are saying that network can be replaced by a single voltage source in series with an internal resistance. That is the simplest way of talking about Thevenin's theorem. In other words, we are saying two-terminal. That means there should be only two points of reference on the circuit. Then linear bilateral, we are saying the behavior of the components or their properties will not change due to the direction of the current. In other words, basically its own passive components, right? That is our assumption. So we are saying it will be replaced by a voltage source in series with an equivalent resistance. So you have a linear two-terminal circuit, right? With terminals A and terminal B, and then the load. So what we are saying is we can vary this load, but we have a fixed equivalent circuit to the left, right? So the components of the circuit will be V or E Thevenin, which is the Thevenin equivalent voltage, and R Thevenin, which is the Thevenin equivalent resistance of the whole network. That's why we are saying any two-terminal linear bilateral network can be replaced by an equivalent voltage source, VThevenin or eThevenin, depending on the textbook that you'll be using, and an equivalent resistance, RThevenin. So what are we saying? We want now to see how then do we create Thevenin's equivalent circuit. In other words, we are saying we might have several sources and resistances, and we want to reduce them to a one voltage and one resistance, which will supply a variable load. That is our focus. So how do we determine Thevenin's equivalent circuit parameters? Remember, Thevenin's equivalent circuit parameters as the Thevenin's voltage and Thevenin's resistance. So one, when you're asked to find Thevenin's equivalent circuit, normally you are given a portion of the circuit which should be excluded from the Thevenin equivalent circuit. So that portion is what we remove from the network first. So maybe I would say find Thevenin's equivalent circuit for circuit external to A and B. In other words, you remove those two portions across which you want to find the equivalent circuit. Okay, so you remove that point. Then you find the equivalent resistance of the remaining circuit as observed from the two terminals where you have removed the other circuit, and you find RThevenin. Now, how do you find RThevenin? All independent sources are removed or are deactivated. If you remember what we're talking about, when we're talking about the superposition theorem, we said you deactivate a voltage source by replacing it with a short circuit, and you deactivate a current source by replacing it with an open circuit. Okay? Deactivate a voltage source by replacing it with a short circuit, and current source by replacing it with an open circuit. Then after that, you find the resistance is observed from the two terminals. Terminals might be A and B, and you want to find the resistance is observed from that direction. Then after that, we find Thevenin's equivalent voltage by reconnecting or reactivating all the sources and finding the open circuit voltage across the terminals. So this will be your RThevenin, right? If our circuit is to the left, then one find the open circuit voltage across that, which is our eThevenin or vThevenin, either eThevenin or vThevenin, then we find the open circuit voltage across that point. Then after that, you will now redraw your circuit with an equivalent resistance and an equivalent voltage. So that is how we deal with Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So now with that example, find Thevenin's equivalent circuit between terminals A and B. So looking at that, it means the first step has been done for us, which means whatever load was connected to that circuit has been removed. So first step, it's done for us. We have removed whatever load there. So we are left with a two terminal circuit. Then after that, we want to find the equivalent resistance according to the circuit that will be left. And we said we find our equivalence by removing the sources first, then we calculate the equivalence. So like I was doing in the previous lecture, let me draw what I'm talking about here in a few seconds. you see how I have removed the sources so that I can calculate the equivalent resistance, because that is our next step in Thevenin, right? And we want to calculate R Thevenin in that direction. So this will be our equivalent circuit. So if you check closely, the reason why I put this lobe is so that I will remember that that is where my voltage source was. So I replaced it with a short circuit. Then here I want to show that that is where my current source was. So I replaced it with an open circuit. So that is what I have. Then I want to calculate the total resistance of that circuit as observed from this side, as observed from the two terminals. So if I'm observing from here, that means I start simplifying from the far end, coming back like that, just like what we're doing when we're considering our sources. So our terminals will be the reference point, and we start simplifying from the other side, right? So let me show how we do that simplification. So if you're looking at that diagram, you see that 5 and 20 are now in series. So I can say R1T for R1 total will be 20 in parallel with 5. And I get my 4 ohms. Then my R total, which is R Thevenin, will be equal to 4 ohms. Now it is in series with the 4 ohms. And I get my 8 ohms as my R Thevenin. I'm not going to explain much because we've done that for the greater part of our lectures. The reason why we took our time is because we are going to use it everywhere. So first, 20 and 5 are in parallel, then in series with 4, you get your 8 ohms as given there. Then the next step will be to calculate the Thevenin equivalent voltage. So what did we say? We replaced all the sources where they were. We replaced all the sources where they were. And then you find the open circuit voltage across the terminals. So as you can see, this circuit is two sources. So that takes us back to superposition theorem. So in this case, what we want to calculate is the open circuit voltage across these two terminals, which is our V Thevenin, right? That is what we want to calculate. Open circuit voltage, that is our V Thevenin. I'm sure we can all see that. So because we have more than one source, we are saying using superposition, right? Superposition theorem. Consider source 25 volt source. 25 volt source. So in other words, we are now removing the current source and want to find the voltage due to the 25 volt source first. So I'll show you the circuit where we have removed the current source. If you don't have volts, your 5 ohms, your 20 ohms, your current source is no longer connected, and the 4 ohm source is still connected, and we have points A and B. Our terminals are A and B, and what we want to find is, now we'll say E Thevenin 1 or E Thevenin V, because they're saying it's E Thevenin due to the voltage source. So I've removed the current source because I'm considering the 25 volt source like that. Okay. So if I look at that circuit, Because terminal A and B is open circuited, it means the four, there's no current into the 4-ohm resistor because it has no path to follow. So what it means is that here I is equal to zero. There's no current going into the what? Into the 4-ohm resistor because there is an open circuit there. So my calculation is now easy. It means if there's no current flowing, then that means the 4-ohm resistor is irrelevant. It's shorted out of the circuit because it has no current flowing. So there's no current flowing into the 4-ohm resistor. I can replace it with a short circuit. So I have a new setup whereby the 5-ohm resistor and the 12-ohm resistor are now forming their own closed loop, and there is no other movement there. So you realize that they now form their own closed loop. So there's only current I, you can say IT, flowing in that circuit, in that loop. There's no current in all other points, right? Then because there is no current in the 4-ohm resistor, voltage is called current times resistance. So there is no voltage drop across the 4-ohm resistor. So E Thevenin will still be the voltage across the 20-ohm resistor. So you realize that E Thevenin V is also the same voltage drop across the 20-ohm resistor, because when there is no current flowing, there's no voltage drop. So this voltage is the same as the voltage at that point. And you can use whatever you want. For me, it's easy to use the voltage divider rule. So using VDR, voltage divider rule, I can say E Thevenin voltage is about 20 over 25 multiplied by 25. And I get my 20 volts, right? But the current is flowing in that way. So the polarity is very important. Remember, superposition, we have to know whether the polarities are adding or are not adding up. So with respect to the voltage source, my current is flowing from the positive to the negative. So according to this, it gives a positive polarity there and a negative polarity there. That is very important. So in other words, according to this, A is positive. A is positive. So A is positive according to the voltage source. Then, since I'm using superposition, I'm now considering the 3-amp current source. I remove the 25 volt source. I have my 5-ohm resistance. I have my 20-ohm resistance. I have my 3-ampere source. And I still have an open circuit there. So I would put that 4-ohm resistor, but my voltage is E Thevenin C for the current source. So I've deliberately omitted the 4-ohm resistor because I said there's no current flowing there. So there's no voltage drop. So there's no need to consider it. Now, the next thing is you want to see where does the Thevenin voltage drop? And we want to see the voltage drop. Where does it drop with respect to those components? So if you check, you realize that A is connected to that. So again, terminal AB is in parallel with the resistor, the 20-ohm resistor. So again, our voltage across the 20-ohm resistor is also the voltage across the terminal A and B. So I know that E Thevenin current is across the 20-ohm resistor. E Thevenin current is across the 20-ohm resistor, but that drop is due to the current source. So I want to see the direction pushed by the current source. So the current source will push a current in the downward direction and in the other direction there. And I'm interested in the current I2 because it is the one which causes the voltage drop across the 12 ohm resistor. So the current will branch at node A into I2 and the other current. And I can use current divider rule to find the current through the 12 ohm resistor. Then after that, I can use Ohm's law to find the voltage across that resistance. So my current I2 will be equal to 5 over 25. Remember, when the branches are in parallel, I take the other side, multiplied by 3 amps. And my current will be equal to 0.6 amps, right? So my current is 0.6 amps if I use the current divider rule. Okay, then after that, what is my voltage? Voltage across the 12 ohm, which is also our eThevenin due to the current source, will now be equal to 0.6 multiplied by 20. And I get my 12 volts. I get my 12 volts for that. That will be the voltage across the 12 ohm resistor, which is also equal to the voltage across A and B. But now I want to see the polarity due to the current source. So due to the current source, my positive terminal is there and my negative is there. So I mark my polarities due to the current source, positive at the top and negative there. And if you look at it, it means A is also positive. A is positive. So what it means is that the two sources are pushing current in the same direction. And resultantly, their overall effect is additive. So our V Thevenin becomes equal to the sum of the two, that's 20 volts plus 12 volts. And that gives us 32 volts as our V Thevenin. They are additive. A is positive in both cases, so we add the two currents, right? The two voltages, sorry. And we get that 32 volts. Then the question says, find Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So the last thing I write is Thevenin's equivalent circuit. And I now draw a 32 volt source in series with an 8 ohm resistor in my terminals A and B. That will be my final answer. So that is Thevenin's equivalent circuit for that example one which we have. I'm sure I've been explaining it slowly enough for everyone to understand. I think I have done that at a very good pace for everyone to understand. So that is the procedure that we use. Remember, that is why I was saying we need to understand the superposition theorem first, then we can proceed to the Thevenin's theorem. Okay, then we can proceed to Thevenin's theorem. So that is what we have. Now, the second example, find Thevenin's equivalent circuit at the terminals A, B of the circuit below. My terminals are A and B. So if I find one to find that, the first stage is to remove the 3-ohm resistor. Remove the 3-ohm resistor first. Then find Thevenin's equivalent resistance across A and B. After that, you find Thevenin's equivalent voltage across A and B. And then you get your results. Can you take a screenshot of that? We'll explain that example when we come back. I'll explain that example when we come back. So that is our with the example. Unless if you are committed, I want to proceed at exactly 2 o'clock. I want to proceed at exactly 2 o'clock. So between now and 2 o'clock, this is the first question. Just take a screenshot. Take a screenshot. Then the practice problem number 4.8. Take a screenshot again of that question. Take a screenshot of that question. Then we'll be done. So this discussion, we have it, but it will be offline. We will not record the discussion. So take a screenshot of the two questions. We are going to use them for our next portion of the lecture. So 2 o'clock, we come back and do those two examples.